Yeah. Nice place, this. You'd like it. Well, you would if you liked six-room flats overlooking Docklands. Panoramic views, the agent said. Extensive balcony with... Actually, I don't know. I don't really use the balcony that much. Don't have the time. Have to make money. Got to make more money. And, well, that's what I do. I make a lot of money. For the people who put their money into the hedge fund I started with some friends. Hedge fund? Okay, what is it? It's a lot of things, but mostly it is what it does. And what it does is take private money and make more money out of it anywhere in the world, even when the stock markets are falling. That's what we did. Me, I'm Harry Towers. I had the contacts.
Harry knows everyone, and if he doesn't, he knows someone who does.
That's Tim Ng, Hong Kong Chinese, maths genius, money magician, the guy who knows what the market's going to do before it does it. It was his fund, his idea.
We invest anywhere in the world where market movements are going to make us money. We hedge against risk. We get rich.
Meredith Parker, market maker, joined us from the States where she'd made some breathtaking trades. We had a few hundred million to work with, nothing big. Things were going well, and then this thing happened. Meredith and the last of us, Ewan, my mate Ewan, tried to pull off a really dumb trade, and we got burned, badly burned, by a big shark named Carmody. I had to try and mend fences with...
Mr. Carmody, Harry Towers from...
I know where you're from, Towers.
I suppose you would, having just burned us.
Well, you shouldn't play with matches, Towers, you and your pals. Not until you're a bit bigger.
No, we understand that, Mr. Carmody. It's just that we'd like the chance to get bigger.
Well?
The guy who set this up, he's on garden leave. We don't like that kind of trading. We pride ourselves on being pretty ethical. We have a sense of decency, and we have...
And what?
We'd really appreciate it if you could hold off calling in the full amount of our debt.
You're wasting my time, Towers. I tell you what, this is the deal, the only deal on the table.
Well, Harry?
We go in with Carmody, become part of his organisation.
I'd rather be dead,
if
Harry.
If we don't, we could be.
I didn't start this fund to be Carmody's monkey. We need to show that SOB that we can ride this thing.
Well, do we have that much leverage?
This isn't about money. Money is easy, right?
Well, if you say so.
Confidence is hard. Because why? Because confidence is everything in this game. We slot it, we need to get it back.
What are we talking about here?
We're talking about talking. You know the story. 100 years ago, a young guy goes up to J.P. Morgan, the biggest banker in the world, and he says, I want you to invest in my product, Mr. Morgan. Mr. Morgan likes this guy, but he never... never invest in this kind of business, so he says...
He says, I tell you what, my boy, be at the stock exchange this afternoon and I will come over and talk to you. You'll be made.
Harry, you got friends. Go get them to talk to you.
Well, that's a hell of a card to play, Tim, at least to try and play. I don't know if I'm ready to sit at that table yet.
If you're not, Harry, what are you doing in this business? Why aren't you still behind a row of screens in some bank's dealing room, making them millions and you pennies?
So, I booked a flight to New York. First class. Confidence, you see.
Wall Street, please. Glasshouse building.
I went to see this friend of my father's. Well, I only met him at my dad's funeral, and maybe he was more a friend of my mum's, but... I always love that drive into New York. It's like slipping slowly into an entirely different...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.